Well, Leo, you've been asking for it and it's now manifesting. Now you might be sitting there asking initially, Leo, where you're like, Velca, what have I been asking for this manifesting? I'll tell you here, the root, whether it's money, whether it's, you know, love or anything like that, the root theme for all of it is a change. You've been craving for a change in direction. With this Wheel of Fortune coming in here, I feel as if you've had a moment sometime recently, Leo, where you're just like, after like you got like a message or like some annoyance or bump in the road has happened in the last week, Leo, you're just like, man, like looking up at the universe and you're like, girl, like what gives? Like what do I need to change? What do I need to do? You might even be feeling as if you've been walking on eggshells just existing in your life, because every step of the way you feel like you check one thing off of your to-do list and then five more things get added and you're just like, well crap, like what do I even do with this here, right? And so I see a lot of changes coming in here for you, Leo. Very, very positive, because even afterwards, you have the Nine of Pentacles with the Three of Cups as well. All right. And so before I talk more, make some more predictions about your future here, my friend, let me introduce myself. Howdy, my beautiful Leo. My name is SimplyVelca. I've been reading tarot cards for over 12 years, my friend. And what makes my tarot readings a little bit different from others as well. Yes, I'll talk about the things that you're manifesting, Leo, but I also, and the good things that you are, but I also like to give you a sense of direction and have you leave my tarot reading understanding of how you go from point A to point B, because what good is knowing all this good stuff that you could manifest, Leo, but you don't know how to get there, all right? So that's my goal when it comes to my tarot readings, is that you get you leave my reading with a sense of clarity and a direction of what to be doing next. I have three rows for you. I have your first row, I'm going to be making some general predictions, and then you will talk about your career, and then we'll talk about your relationships in your life, all right? So if I sound like the type of tarot reader for you, Leo, let's get right back into this year. So ultimately, right, the Wheel of Fortune, why is this even occurring though? It's occurring because you're in this place right now, Leo, as the Queen of Swords. Your spiritual team is trying to get you out of your shell. And the best way to get you out of your shell is by having some good things happen for you, right? Because the only reason why you're in this Queen of Swords state of like survival mode, or just not really doing much of anything, just really minding your own business and just not coloring outside of the lines any, is because of just the life that you've been like because as I said beforehand, you've been feeling like every step of the way is like you say something, someone always has a problem, you do something, like it's always something is what I hear, Leo. And so where this Wheel of Fortune is going to be starting to bless you with is that I won't be surprised, Leo, if you start hearing some positive news when it comes to your career, all right? Getting some positive news, especially, Leo, if you have been in this place recently when it comes to your own personal projects. Maybe you've been feeling a little bit frustrated and like, you know, let's just say, for example, if I was a Leo, I'd be like, okay, you know, maybe the tarot content that I'm creating, I might be frustrated. That's not the case, by the way, but in this analogy here, I might be frustrated with not getting enough views on my content, making it's like, okay, is this even worth it? In this message here, I feel as if I would be getting signs from my spiritual team of like extra momentum, things to inspire me to want to create more. And so I would be expecting to get more views from this, right? Obviously, that's an analogy. I really don't feel that way. I feel very blessed, but I like to use analogies, Leo, so you have a better understanding of how you would apply that to your life here. Because I do get this sense of like a little bit of frustration, a little bit of like being a little bit critical of yourself, Leo, because there's a sense of where I feel like you've been wanting better results with things here, and I promise you that change is coming. I also get like this message, Leo, when it comes to your social life, either like you're going to be making some new friends, some new acquaintances in the coming days. And I also want to be either that, or there's this message, Leo, it's going to be either or, of where you're going to be getting invited out to do certain things like events or something in that manner there. I think it's really important for you to be accepting any type of invitation at this time, Leo, and not to say that you're going to meet some new folks from that, but there's relevance from your spiritual team where it's just like, accept the invitation. That's like, I might even title your video this way because I really do feel like it's such a relevant thing for you. It's like, accept the invitation, whether that invitation is the opportunity for you to apply somewhere or whether the invitation is to go out. By you accepting that invitation, you won't regret it, all right? And then the Nine of Pentacles. Now I'm speaking more so towards those who are personally like self-employed or trying to get something off of the ground, right? A personal project, maybe a book, social media, what have you here. Be expecting some good news in that regard as well. Really, ultimately, the energy that's going to be coming to you this week is with the intent of helping you to put down that sword, where it's like you can start breathing again, start feeling safe and not be in survival mode, and start being able to like appreciate life a little bit again, and rather than always feeling like you have to do some type of damage control, right, Leo? So speaking of, let's just, if you see me making a face like right now, I have a sneeze coming in. All right, Leo, sorry about that. I had a sneeze, so I had to edit that out because I don't think y'all want to hear a high definition sneeze to me, honey. Anyways, let's go into your career now and your just physical personal endeavors that are going on. And so the overall energy for this here, Leo, is the Two of Swords. All right, a crossroads being presented right in front of you here, and what that crossroads is in the shape of is this shadow card. Now this is the Devil in this tarot deck here, but facing a shadow of yours here. All right, and so this crossroads that's being presented in front of you for your career, y'all had to get over your imposter syndrome or your shyness here. You know what, like, what is this about? Like, what is the shadow even about, Leo? Girl, I swear to God, if it comes in as like some type of insecurity, honey, insecurity, and then King of Wands, and then the Page of Cups clarifying this. And so where the shadow is coming in is the sense of being perceived, which makes no sense whatsoever, especially for my Leos that would gain success or gain further abundance in their life by getting more recognition or attention here. Leo, you need to just accept the fact that you are King of Wands, and even if other people don't perceive you as the King of Wands, nothing's going to happen unless you allow it to happen. All right, that's something I've had to learn even in my my career, social media, and putting myself out there, is that I always felt weird to present myself as like an authority, right, or anything in that manner, or just to not feel cocky but just feel confident, right, in my content. And I'm very confident in my content, but I was always so afraid of having it be misinterpreted. Even right now I was like trying to find different words so I wasn't misinterpreted here. The better, and so this lets you know, like, I'm speaking about this, but it's a very normal human thing, and it's like something we all go through, right? So I can speak about it so well because I go through it, honey. It's stages. And so yeah, stop feeling like you need to explain yourself, Leo. If someone doesn't want to like you, darling, they're going to not like you. All right, they're going to find something to not like you. I could choose to not wear nails, makeup, and anything, and have the deepest voice possible, honey, like, ugh, and do these tarot readings, and still someone that doesn't want to like me is still going to find something that I do and just dislike me for it, right? And so I might as well just wear the makeup, because rather than having them find something else to dislike me about, I'll just make it easy for them and be like, oh, you know, I don't like this person because they wear a duck earring, so they're not clearly spiritual. And does that make sense, Leo? And so truly, if you've been like in your shell recently just because of like the anxiety of the outside world and how they perceive you, like, please heed the words that I'm saying right now, Leo, and that you are what's stopping you from being able to have this Ten of Cups, where you have extreme fulfillment in your bank account, your career, in your social life, everything, you know. And that's really the key with this Chariot energy here. Once you are able to acknowledge this crossroads, where it's like you can't continue going forward in your life, Leo, without addressing that shadow, without you addressing this fear of attention and fear of, like, if you were to put yourself out there, if you would even be able to get the opportunities, right? Again, if I was reading these tarot cards for myself as an analogy here, I would see this and be like, okay, like, I'm afraid of putting myself out there doing tarot, because what if I put myself out there and I'm forever, you can Google me, right, of tarot, and then what if it doesn't work out? Then I have like this past of tarot and that looks weird. Darling, don't pay attention to that, all right? By you just being the King of Wands, you'll have the fast forward momentum in your career to have extremely validating things to be happening in your life. You just have to commit to the new path in the first place here, Leo. You have to not only, and what that commitment looks like is not just you being like, oh, Velca, I want to start a YouTube channel, and then you create the YouTube channel, right? And then maybe you put one video out there, two videos out there where you don't even show your face, right? That's not fully committing to the Two of Swords. You have one foot in, one foot out. If you truly want to have like a successful YouTube career, it's like, girl, get in front of the camera. It's not mandatory, but every successful YouTuber, like 99% of successful channels, have a face in front of them, right? Get over what's stopping you from creating content and being in front of the camera, because once you get over that hump, then everything changes. You need to fully commit to this new path, and you can't commit to the path of being like, oh, I want to be a social media influencer, but still have that shyness and not really want to command authority in what it is that you're speaking about. Does that make sense, Leo? So enough about that. Let's talk about your relationships now. Could be with the now this person that I'm tuned into, could be romantic, platonic, past, present, future, darling, friendship, family. That's not up to me to fill in those details. It's up to you, darling. All right. But the case seems to be with this here. Leah, I feel very strongly in that you're going to be hearing back from somebody that is like initially an acquaintance, right? The type of dynamic that I get here is that not much communication. You guys have crossed paths beforehand, and the details are a little bit fuzzy to me, but I feel as if like there's this desire from both on both sides, from your side, Leo, and the others, like you wanted to connect more with one person, this person, and they wanted to connect more with you. But I feel like on some level here, whatever the case was, it just couldn't happen. Four of Cups, maybe someone was really distracted in their life and they were not able to be present. So maybe you tried to communicate with them, started on a texting basis, but they were like bad texters, for example, here. Dawn of Swords coming in here lets me know that they're paying attention to you still. All right. Paying attention to the social media here. And then the Two of Cups coming in. And then because it's under the guise of the Ten of Cups, Leo, definitely someone like an acquaintance coming back into your life, or somebody that you haven't been able to, someone that you haven't communicated with in a while, Leo, and you wanted to get to know more, but maybe you felt like they weren't emotionally available or just putting much effort in. And I feel like the reason why the relationship couldn't really grow and develop to be like a good friendship or anything is like, well, yes, y'all are good people, good match. Something was just really taking up a lot of their energy, so they couldn't reciprocate in the way that they want to, but they haven't forgotten about you. And so be anticipating some type of acquaintance trying to make their appearance more strong back into your life again, Leo. All right, seems to be pretty authentic feelings and emotions. So yeah, this is the weekly tarot reading that I have for you today, Leo. Hopefully something in here resonated. If you're looking for further clarity in your life, you can book a one-on-one tarot reading with me on my website down below, simplyvelca.com. Until next time, I love you so much, Leo. Bye.